clowns for the wide open spaces.
What he means is that it's some little pit town that nobody's ever heard of.
Hey, people have heard of it.
Oh, yeah? What's the name of it?
You can find it on any map.
What's the name of it?
People are flocking there from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the heck is Beaumont?
I can't put it in the back seat. The trunk is full.
Friend, don't start. I don't want to leave any more than you do.
Then let's not go.
Look, I too wish your father hadn't left, and I too wish things could be the way they were.
Okay, okay.
And we both wish I could be one of those strong, single moms who suddenly become self-sufficient. But I'm not. Please, feel free to disagree.
Mom, we have a 10-hour drive. We have plenty of time to disagree.
Ourselves. Have I done the right thing?
Have I done the right thing?
On the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up.
Well, then, Ariel, why don't you just talk to him?
Why? He never listens to me anyway. And besides, I welcome to Beaumont.
Abby!
Ooh, you are cute!
Say, Wendy Joe, isn't he cute? I bet he knows he's cute. Don't you think, Wendy Joe?
Ooh, okay! Well, I'll see you later!
Hey, put your tongues back in your mouth and let's get out of here.
See ya.
Where are you going?
Where do you think?
Oh!
And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all night, right?
Wait. Are you asking us to, like, lie for you?
Yeah.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Kristen, what are you doing with preacher's daughter?
Anything I want.
Yeah? What is she now?
Everything that she needs.
Like you know.
Well, she like you to think she was born yesterday with her innocent looks and a little town way. And she smiles at you, she's got angels in her eyes. But I've seen out the moon that this girl with the cooks. She's talking to me, and I'm starting to think she's the devil in disguise. The girl gets around.
Cold.
Good evening, Reverend.
Hey, Ariel, right?
Yeah, so?
I'm Ren. Ren McCormick. We met after church. Is this a small world or what? I'm your new classmate.
Howdy! Leave that poor boy alone.
Hey, mister, you bugged me.
Sorry.
Don't you ever look where you're going?
I said I was sorry.
You got a new guy from Chicago, ain't you?
Perhaps.
Smart aleck, huh? Listen, around here, you push somebody, they push you back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Got it. Let me ask you a question. Do they sell men's clothing where you got that hat?
What's that, some kind of stupid joke?
No. That's a really good joke.
That's it, man. I'm gonna kill you. Do it! Kill me, please! Huh? Kill me! Kill me! That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I picked town!
Ryan McCormick. And you're?
Willard. Willard Hewitt.
Willard, what do you do around here to have fun? You have any clubs?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
What about movies?
Nope.
Oh, what about...
Nope, nope, and nope. We do have the Bolarama down at the interstate.
What? I really admire you. I could never do what you guys do around here.
Oh yeah? What do we do?
Nothing! I never walked an eye. I don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should get back into touch. I can't stand still.
I can see that.
I called the doctor, he said, son, I can't offer you a pill. So I never found relief. Now I've got to move until I've had my pill. I can't stand still. Watch my P's and Q's. Baby, look before I leave. Then I think they was the youth. Hey, darling, yeah. I can't forget how it feels when you can't see you drop. Don't even trust the check that I stop.
The longest in
McCormick. It's so attractive watching a guy fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Wendy Jeff?
Was she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law?
Has been for 5.5 years, ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Bhutani Bridge accident?
You've never heard of the Bhutani Bridge accident.
If I'd heard of the Bhutani Bridge accident, would I be doing this?
Well, ladies, should I take this one?
Oh, please.
Be my guest. There were these four kids we all grew up with, and they were driving back from a big dance over in Baylor County. Now, maybe it was the rain that night, maybe they were being a little wild, but somehow they lost control of the car. It skidded across the bridge, crashed through the railing, and fell 35 feet into the Bhutani River.
Whoa, did anybody survive? Oh my.
Yeah, and when the sheriff's office published the autopsy report, it showed there was alcohol and marijuana in their blood.
Well, everybody in the town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous. He blamed everything and anything. Drugs, liquor, rock and roll.
And dancing.
You got it.
He convinced the town council that it was all a sin, and just like that, they passed this law.
Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power.
He is the law.
How do you guys continue to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice.
It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a city where you can walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. I thought living in a small town was going to be perfect. Like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing everywhere you turn.
There's head shakes the minute you cross the line.
And there's eyes everywhere.
Careful what you do. Someone's watching you. Cause you're on display every night and every day. Somebody's hiding in the great unknown. And every time you think that you're alone, ha! Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are seeing.
Thanks for the advice, but it's not going to get to me.
Gets to everyone.
You don't know me.
You don't know Beaumont.
Somebody, 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 somebody died. Whoa. Somebody, 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 somebody died. Whoa.
Hey! Herbert Avalon, if your Beaumont stop sign means stop.
But I thought I did.
Now radio music of yours is blasting pretty loud.
So you pulled me over because my music was too loud.
Hey! What's that attitude, boy?
Welcome, Jim.
Is it one of yours, Chuck?
The city kid? I wouldn't want him, just my boy.
Oh, he seems nice.
Careful how you speak. Turn the other cheek. Be careful how you speak.
Think of nothing, and if you get caught, well, then boy, you bought a lot.
Somebody, somebody, somebody.
and you get fired.
Every day is more bad news with you. Every day.
Lulu, don't exaggerate. Red, what did happen?
Nothing I should be fired for. Willard came by the store asking for change from a dollar. So I opened up the cash register. But when Mr. Dillingham came out and saw my hand in the drawer, he went crazy. He accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No! But why don't you frisk me? Because I'm sure you've already gone through everything in my room.
Ren, apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know I'm not your father.
You can say that again!
Wes!
Don't say anything, Echo.
I can't do that, Wes. You know I don't know how to do that.
Pumpkin, hush, please.
Look, Wes, I realize that we're guests in your home, but—
Echo, right now, just don't say anything.
Never left you alone.
What's a few more minutes?
My dad is still not crazy about me seeing you.
Tell him what he used to it.
You tell him.
I will. Reverend.
Maybe not right now. I'm not in the mood for one of his sermons. Go home. Go. Hi, Daddy. Mom.
You hungry?
I'm starving. What's this? Don't tell me. Haydn. The second sonata?
The fourth.
Number four. Right. I guess this kind of music's okay, huh, Daddy?
Meaning?
She's just making a joke, Shaw.
I'm aware of that vibe.
Are you working on your sermon?
I am.
Remember when I was a kid, and on Saturdays, I would sit in a pew down front and listen to you practice over and over again.
I do indeed.
And then you would bow and I would clap.
Well, you seem to have outgrown that.
Shaw, what just happened? Did I say something wrong?
Your father's had a difficult day.
Why, I can speak for myself.
Honey, why don't you help me set the table?
I'm not really hungry. Shaw, if you're angry with Ariel, would you please tell her why?
Not angry, I'm concerned.
Then just talk to her. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Have you seen her with this Chuck Cranston? The last time I walked in on the two of them—
You told me.
The boy has a record of arrests, but—
And the more you object, the more interested she's going to be.
What, so I should hold my peace?
I do, and I pray that her infatuation with Chuck Cranston lasts no longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not an overheated delinquent.
Oh, he most certainly was.
This is not funny.
I'm just trying to lighten the mood.
Well, I can't. I'm frightened about where Ariel is and what she's doing.
You can't just expect her to sit home with us.
Let's stop this conversation right here.
Conversation?
Bye.
I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Please, let's not say something we might regret.
Rusty.
Hi, Willard.
We'll see ya.
Hi, Willard.
That's it.
You two are pathetic.
When are you two going to have a real conversation?
Oh, Willard is not capable of a real conversation.
I gotta put that in the bag.
Oh, hey, Ren. How's the new job?
Well, it's already my second day, and I haven't been fired yet.
You may have found your future.
I may have. What can I get started for you guys?
Diet Coke. I have a hula burger double patty cheese melt with extra mayo and ordered fries and a Diet Coke.
And Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Oh!
Chuck sees you flirting with Ariel. You're a dead man.
She usually doesn't even remember me.
Well, that outfit makes you look like such a loser. It's easier to pick you out.
You are always looking for a fight, aren't you, Willard?
Mama says it's in my nature.
Shut up. Tell me what you know about Ariel.
Well, I know she's been kissed. A lot.
And?
And she's on you like a hog on slop.
Get out of town!
Ariel likes trouble, and you have definitely proved to this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Come on. I was only teasing him.
That's more than teasing. Ren's from out of town, and don't tell me that doesn't curl your toes.
You went out of Beaumont so bad, I bet you memorized the bus schedules.
Besides, you said you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly. It looks either to be guys that amaze me.
And what about Ren?
What about him?
He's sort of smart.
He's pretty tall.
I think he's handsome.
Cute, maybe.
But can he really compete with Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout / drug dealer who was recently evicted from a trailer park? Yeah, I don't think so.
So what's the deal with you and Rusty?
I don't know. She's good looking and all, but I never know what the heck she's talking about. Talks faster than any girl I've ever met.
That's because she likes you.
You think?
If only I could find a guy who'd make the first move.
If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, took the toothpick out of his mouth.
If only I could find a guy.
Thank you. 8:30. Why? Oh no.
Ariel! Where the hell have you been?
We had a date over half an hour ago.
I know. I'm sorry.
I don't like it when you make a fool out of me.
And why would you? You do such a good job of it yourself.
Shut up,
Rusty. Will you be joining these ladies for dinner? When I say, meet me at 8, what am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right, I need to calm down.
Don't! You tell me to calm down. Never tell me to calm down. I know what your friends think of me, and it's bull crap. I'm the best party in this town, baby. Those three dogs ought to be tied up under the porch. Get me drunk.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no! What part of that don't you understand, Chuck?
Oh, and the preacher's daughter.
Leave me alone, Chuck!
Hey, I believe the lady said
and
no!
I believe this is none of your business.
Friend, don't.
Eric, who invited this clown? Oh, I'm so sorry, we've never been formally introduced. Ren McCormick.
Get your hand out of my face and get your face out of my sight!
Hey, Chuck, you looking for me?
Oh, yeah, what the
fuck? Miller, don't make me lose this time!
Let me in! Let me in!
Come on,
hey! We got a problem here?
No, ma'am. Me and the guys are just discussing the comfort and safety of one of your bank customers.
What?
Fun is funny.
Cranston, your pickup truck is in the handicapped parking, which is a space we reserve for people with physical, not emotional disabilities.
You haven't seen the last of me, McCormick. Can I please just kick his butt?
Well, what's that your mama says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this is not your fight. Not with the rest of you at the parking. And McCormick.
I know. I'll turn in my uniform.
You listen to me. I'll see you here after school tomorrow.
Really? So I'm not fired?
Not yet, you're not. I'm going to start closing up shop. I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
Haven't made up my mind. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Oh my gosh, you're right. Please, my daddy invented it. And besides, don't you think rules are meant to be broken? Come on.
Cranston's girlfriend.
Guilty.
Just a church-going gal with some really nice red cowgirl boots.
My daddy hates me wearing these boots.
You love that, don't you? Getting all up in his face.
That way he'll notice when I'm gone.
Where are you going?
College, for starters. I've applied to some places my daddy doesn't even know about. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. My daddy wants me to teach English Lit in Baylor County. They don't even speak English in Baylor County.
I cannot picture you as a teacher.
Thank you. Neither can I. I'll leave that to my daddy.
Your dad's a preacher, not a teacher.
When you're good at it, it's the same thing. And he used to be real good.
What made him change?
His mind. He closed it.
I noticed.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. I've seen him give hope when hope was gone. I've watched him change lives.
If you love him so much, why do you always want to tick him off?
I didn't say I love him.
Do I know what that's like? My dad, he...
Yeah. What happened there?
He just walked out. He just walked out the door. No goodbye, no nothing.
I bet you've got lots to say to him.
Lots.
Like?
No, I couldn't.
Tell it to the train. It's what I do.
Tucker's to be so stupidly bombing me! I hate you!
Feel better?
I'm not sure.
Do you want to kiss me?
Someday?
Someday? What do you mean, someday?
Well, I'm afraid you've been kissed a lot. And I fear I'd suffer from comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you? Well,
no, I think of you a lot more than I expected. Come on, I'll take you home.
Okay, let's see. Harriet, you owe Eleanor.
And Reverend, you owe me that before.
Eleanor, why is it the place my prayers only seem to fail in is at the bridge table?
Come on, just say hello to everybody. Hi! You all know Reverend McCormick. Daddy, Ren.
Hey, Reverend. How's it going? Coach Dunbar. Principal Clark.
Hi, Mrs. Dunbar.
Mrs. Moore.
Welcome, Ren.
Oh, poker night. Cool.
Ariel, all this time we thought you were upstairs in your room.
Doing your homework.
It's hard to impose a curfew on the young people of my congregation when I can't seem to enforce one at my own home.
Well, what's the old saying? It's always the shoemaker's children that always go barefoot. This is yours?
Ren, thanks for, you know.
Walking you home?
Yeah, that too.
Well, this was fun, Reverend, don't you think? I really blew it in there, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
I get so nervous, I go crazy. And I always end up putting my foot in my mouth. Good night, Mrs. Moore.
Good night.
I don't want you to see him again.
Ren? Why? Just because he hasn't lived in this town his whole life?
No, that's not it. But clearly the boy has no respect for authority, and everyone tells me he's a troublemaker.
Who's everyone? The principal? Give me a break.
Ariel, what am I going to do with you?
With me? Daddy, lately it seems all you do is look for the worst in people, and then of course you find it.
My, where did that come from?
From you, Daddy! Today's sermon is the world is evil, evil, and Ariel should be locked away in a tower!
That's a little melodramatic, don't you think?
No, I don't! Daddy, you make me feel like a prisoner, and I hate it! I just hate it!
Someone's got to put a foot down.
I didn't say anything.
I I don't enjoy being her jailer. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How could I just let her go? I strive to be a good creature. I try not to go overboard. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I face my Lord? Heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle. Still, someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, to spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was the plan. But I might have thought twice if only I knew that I'd spend all of my time saying, no, no, don't do that. See, everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have the rules. So heaven help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors?
My whistle isn't working. This is not a good day. All right. So today we're going to be taking a break from squats. Instead, we're going to do some crunches. Crunches. We're going to do crunches. Everybody get down on the ground and do some crunches.
Slow folks.
Come on.
Coach.
McCormick, you and your friends are late.
Coach, Brenda's hurt. Look at his eye.
Don't waste your breath or my time with another lame excuse.
It's not an excuse. Last night after running off me home, some guys jumped in.
There was like six of them.
Willard, there's like three guys.
Anybody you know?
I didn't take any names if that's what you were asking.
McCormick, it seems when you're not looking for trouble, it finds you anyway. And Ariel, I would encourage you to stay away from this guy. I've been asked to keep an eye on you.
Oh, and my father called you. Surprise, surprise.
And if you would just cooperate, it would make all of our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy gives you a call, you get off of my back?
You know what? That big mouth of yours is probably what made your daddy walk out in the first place.
Count to 10. Mama says he's count to 10.
It'd be wise to take your friend's advice. Ariel, get back to practice. McCormick, get down and give me 30.
You're joking.
You're right. Make it 50.
He's not faking, Coach. He's really hurt.
Well, thank you for your diagnosis, Dr. Willard. You can give me 50 as well. In fact, you can all give me 50. Courtesy of Lister McCormick.
One, two.
I cannot hear you.
Three.
Four. 46 more to go.
I'm sorry, guys. This whole town is just so bummed up.
Amen.
You have nowhere to blow off any steam.
You said it.
At least in Chicago, we had the clubs.
Hey, maybe we ought to take Coach Dance.
Well, then you are so...
What? What are you thinking?
That's it! We're gonna throw a dance. We are going to throw a party that knocks Beaumont right off its track.
Oh, no, you were just asking for a fight.
Bring it on. I'll take on anybody.
Will you take on the town council?
I'll fight City Hall. If there's one thing worth fighting for, it's freedom.
Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. If anything's worth the fear, it's worth the fight. No one can tie my hands and make me change my plans. We're crossing the line, jumping the track, taking what's mine and not looking back. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. Every day I face a new frontier. I can't worry what the world will say.
Maybe that law needs changing.
Hello? Beaumont is never going to let us forget the Pawtucket Bridge accident.
How long are you going to live in that shadow? There must be a way out of this.
The only way out of here is by train.
No. Listen.
Running away will never make you free. It doesn't matter where you go, I guarantee. We're shaking the past, making our breaks, taking control, that's what it takes. Heaven helps the man to fight his fear. We can face it down right now, right here. When you're standing on your own to me, you will not retreat if you
try it.
I'm free.
Let the Lord hear your voices.
I'm free.
Yes.
We're taking our path, making our break, taking control. That's what it takes.
I'm free.
Promise of Beaumont's brightest future.